Okay, one last time. These are small, but the ones out there are far away.
Anyway, any idea why July the 19th should be so important?
Would that be the day the Ice Age ended?
No, Dougal. It can't be that precise about the Ice Age.
I look it up in the diary. July 19th. On this day, Galway liberated from Indians. Mm-hmm. Marathon becomes Snickers. Mm-hmm. A hat head, Ice Age ends.
Never met anyone like him anyway. Who would he be like, Hitler or one of those mad fellas? Oh, worse than Hitler. You wouldn't find Hitler playing jungle music at 3 o'clock in the morning.
He's just a shadow of a sheep.
I'm not surprised, Ted. If I was a sheep, I'd be watching my back right now.
Why?
Because of the beast. They say it's as big as 4 cats, and it's got a retractable leg so as it can leap up at you better. But you know what, Ted? It lights up at night, and it's got 4 ears. 2 of them are for listening, and the other 2 are kind of backup ears. And its claws are as big as cups, and for some reason, it's got a tremendous fear of stamps. Mrs. Doyle was telling me that it's got magnets on its tail, so as if you're made out of metal, it can attach itself to you. And instead of a mouth, it's got 4 arses.
Dougal! It's a legend. It doesn't exist.
Right, Ted. The way the Phantom of the Opera doesn't exist.
The Phantom of the Opera doesn't exist! Look, I'm not going to get into this what does exist and what doesn't exist debate again, OK? But I'm going to have to insist you add those last 2 examples to the chart.
But, Ted,
Dougal!
How do you feel? Must be great to be sober every once in a while, or even every 12 years.
Chair!
Well done, Father.
Curtains!
Yes, that's right!
Floor!
All coming back to you, is it, Father?
Gobshite!
Dougal, do you remember Sister Sumter?
No.
She was here last year, and then we stayed with her in the convent, back in Kildare. Do you remember it?
Ah, you do.
And then you were hit by the car when you went down to the shops for the paper. You must remember all that. And then you won £100 with your lottery card.
Ah, you must remember it, Dougal.
Weren't you accidentally arrested for shoplifting? I remember we had to go down to the police station to get you. And the police station went on fire? And you had to be rescued by helicopter?
Do you remember?
You can't remember any of that.
Huh? The helicopter! When you fell out of the helicopter.
Over the zoo.
Do you remember the tigers?
You don't remember.
You were wearing your blue jumper.
Ah, Sister Assumpta, hello there.
Hello.
Drink? Oh, yes.
No.
No?
No, Father Slend. Remember, you said you'd give it up for a couple of days.
What?
Do you not remember? You said you'd offer it up for our Lord.
Arnold? Who's Arnold?
No. Our Lord. I suppose I made your vow for you, but I know that deep down inside you'd like to make a little sacrifice.
Why we can't look at aliens?
Dougal, Bishop O'Neill is speaking.
But they'd love it, Ted.
No, they wouldn't.
Bishops love sci-fi.
Dougal, we are not watching aliens!
Ted, you're not going to believe this. Clint Eastwood has been arrested for a crime he didn't... Oh, wait, no, it's a film.
All right, Crilly, I'll make this short. Show me the likeness and I'll be off. I have to be off to Rome tomorrow for an audience with the Pope.
I love those programmes. Have you seen the one with Elton John?
Aha, the Kraken awakes. Did we disturb you, Father Hackett?
Ice biscuits!
What? How dare you speak to His Grace like that? Apologize immediately!
I'm so sorry.
Dougal, don't take it so seriously. It's just a bit of fun.
Just play the f***ing note.
First one.
No, not the f***ing first one. The f***ing first one's already f***ing down. Just play the f***ing note you're f***ing playing earlier. I've been playing the f***ing first one. We have the f***ing first one.
I hear you're a racist now, Father.
What?
How did you get interested in that type of thing?
Who said I'm a racist?
Everyone's saying it, Father. Should we all be racist now? What's the official line the church is taking on this?
Oh, no.
Only the farm takes up most of the day, and at night I'd just like a cup of tea. I might be able to devote myself full-time to the old racism.
Good for you, Father.
What? Oh, Mrs. Carberry.
Good for you, Father. Well, someone had the guts to stand up to them at last. Coming over here, taking our jobs and our women, and acting like they own a second place. Well done, Father. Good for you. Good for you. I fight a second. Second Greeks.
It isn't the Greeks, it's the Chinese he's after.
I am not after the Chinese.
I don't care who we get so long as I can have a go at the Greeks. They invented gayness.
Ted, I want out.
What do you mean?
I went too far too soon. I didn't know what I was getting into, Ted. I didn't know you had to follow up a good idea with loads more little good ideas. I'm sorry, Ted. I'm going to sleep in the spare room.
Chairman Mao, Secretary of the Communist Party of China, one of the biggest communist parties in the world, and in my view, the best. And I'd like to thank you all for coming here tonight. And of course, you'll have a bit of an old chat.
I know what's going on, Pat Mustard. There are some very hairy babies on Craggy Island, and I think you are the hairy baby maker.
No, yeah? Well, I think that you would need proof if you're going to make that sort of an accusation. And I'm a very careful man, Father. A very careful man.
Except when it comes to taking precautions in the bedroom.
No! You wouldn't be advising the use of artificial contraception now, Father, would you?
Yes, I...
No, I...
If you're going to be... Of course, you... Just feck off!
Any doubts you've been having about any aspects of belief? Anything like that?
Well, you know the way God made us all, right? And he's looking down at us from heaven and everything.
Uh-huh.
And then his son came down and saved everyone and all that.
Yes.
And when we die, we're all going to go to heaven.
Yes. What about it?
Well, that's the bit I've trouble with.
Baron Island Parochial House, Father Beeching here.
Dougal's in trouble. He got a job as a milkman, and the previous milkman has put a bomb on the milk float that will blow up when the milk float goes under 4 miles an hour.
Yes, that is a problem. But don't panic, Ted.
We've got to do something practical, something that will really help Dougal.
Wait, I have it.
Lord be with you. Today is being offered for Father Dougal McGuire.
Well, it's worked for them and they saved hundreds of lives. We only have to save one.
That was different. The Towering Inferno was a big building that caught fire. You can't apply the same criteria to rescuing a priest from an explosive milk float. And besides, they had Paul Newman and Steve McQueen.
God almighty, it's so long since I've seen it, I forgot Steve McQueen was in it.
Wait!
Those women were in the nip!